Today we are talking all about hypodermoclysis. Welcome back, my name is Tammy and this is NurseMinder, and on this channel we do everything nursing. So if you're new here, consider subscribing below so that you get the next video when it's released. So before we start looking at how to insert and care for our hypodermoclysis, we need to know why we're using it so that we can make sure it's the right treatment for the right reason. For some patients, they're just not safe to take fluid or medications through the oral route. Maybe they've got a risk for aspiration, dysphagia. Another one might be they have a malabsorption and they just can't absorb things in their belly. And the second main reason that we use hypodermoclysis is because the veins in their hands and their arms are so poor we can't see them, we can't hit them, they're too thin, they're too fragile, so we're just going to go to a hypodermoclysis. When it comes to site selection, we're looking for pockets of subcutaneous tissue, and there are some preferred sites. So for example, we've got the back of the arm here, lots of subcutaneous tissue there, coming across the anterior chest just under the clavicle. This is another good location. Again, you can go across the body, so we've got the two arms and the two anterior chest. We can also go behind the back, the scapula, and just above it. That's another great place. And of course, we all know the abdomen has a lot of subcutaneous tissue. I am not going to show you mine. But then the other place would be the legs. We can go anterior thigh or lateral thigh. In terms of supplies, we will need a chlorhexidine swab to clean the area for 30 seconds. If your patient is allergic to this, you can use an alcohol swab. We will need our catheter, our HDC. We'll need our tegaderm to secure it, and we'll need our neutral connector to attach after we've pulled out the sheath, and of course your gloves. So after we've washed our hands, we would start the procedure. What we want to do now is to prepare our equipment. So we're going to open up our package. First thing is to check the expiry date, and then we can open this up. I'm going to get my swab ready. My securing device, that's ready to go. Open up my neutral connector. Step one, clean the site. We're going to use our chlorhexidine pad here and we're going to scrub for 30 seconds. We initially begin with some firm pressure using strokes going up and down, and we want to cover a nice base there to reduce the microorganisms as we're going to be entering the skin. So after we've completed a 15 second scrub going up and down, we're now going to flip the chlorhexidine pad and we're going to use a back and forth motion, and we're going to continue for another 15 seconds to ensure that the site is prepared efficiently for our insertion. Now, once it is completed, we will let it air dry. It's important to note that we do not fan the site. So next, we're going to get our gloves on, grab our HDC, take the cathalon off, and pinch our skin gently. You don't want to grab too deep because you'll get muscle. I've got the HDC in my fingers so that I'm holding on to the bubbled edge. Catheter tip is up. Quick insertion into the subcutaneous tissue, and we're going to secure that. Grasp the plastic end and just simply pull out the needle from your HDC. And you're left with your catheter in situ. Now is the time to grab your dressing and we're going to secure the HDC so we do not lose the line that we've just inserted. Go ahead and pull off the backing. Ensure that we have a nice seal all the way around our tegaderm. We can go ahead then and exchange the cap for a neutral connector. All that's left to do next is to lock off the line and make sure we put our label on it. Now the label needs to have the date of insertion, the type of drug, and the concentration of the drug, because this is going to be a dedicated line. Today we've learned how to insert an HDC or a hypodermoclysis. I've got a bunch of other videos here just for you. Take a look around, and until next time, have a great day.